Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy, with another in the series. What you're looking at, of course, is the Edison Model C reproducer. Now, I've been getting a lot of questions about the reproducer, and in particular, how do you rebuild it? How do you go about repairing one of these? If the diaphragm's broken, if the link's broken, if the stylus itself is broken or damaged, how do you repair and how do you disassemble a Model C reproducer? So I thought I'd do a quick video and go step by step, show you exactly how to do it. It's not difficult, but I have to warn you, you're working with some extremely small parts. So you're going to need a pair of tweezers and you're going to need a jeweler's screwdriver. For right now, that's the only two tools you need. So as you can see, this is a standard Model C. What we're going to do is disassemble it step by step, show you exactly how to do this. Now, this is the hinge block. There's a screw in the hinge block that is extremely small. It's about the diameter of a sewing needle, and it's threaded. The pin that goes through the stylus is equally small, and it is, in fact, a threaded pin. It is not actually a screw. It's only threaded about four or five turns on the very top near the head. The rest of it is a very, very extremely small pin. So I'm just going to do a quick video to show you how to pull this apart, change whatever parts you might need, and then reassemble it. So the very first thing we're going to do is take our jeweler screwdriver. We're going to go to the hinge block, and we are going to remove this hinge pin. And it takes about five or six turns. It's only threaded right on this end. The rest of it is strictly a pin. So now that it's unthreaded, we can grab it with a pair of tweezers, maybe we can, and pull it out. As you can see, for now, leave it there. Just make sure it's loose. Now, the pin for the stylus is threaded as well, equally small, and about four turns it will unscrew, and you'll feel the threads as they pop out. So once you've unthreaded it, grab it with a pair of tweezers and pull the pin out of the reproducer. Now you can see how small this is. Do not drop it. If you lose this, your reproducer is disabled until you find a replacement. So we've removed the pin for the stylus. Now we're going to remove the pin for the hinge. So, notice nothing's changed. We haven't tried to move anything at all. So now, with a small pair of tweezers or with your fingers, just lift up on the stylus, pull it out of its cutout, and just let it flop there. Now, remember, we've got a limit pin on this side. A lot of the directions tell you to remove that limit pin. You don't need to. All you need to do now is lift up on the back of the reproducer, on the wing, the tail weight. It'll come up off of the hinge, the stylus falls through the hole, pull the pin out of the limit loop, and you have removed the tail weight. Now, to remove the stylus itself, notice it's hanging by a link. You simply unhook it from the diaphragm and set it aside. Now, this is the diaphragm itself. This is what's actually making the noise. And you can see this one is really badly rusted, which is surprising. So in any case, there's a retaining ring right here, and it's knurled at the top to give you something to push against, but it actually has two cutouts. One there, one there. First, we're going to see if we can move this ring at all, just using our thumb. And we can a little bit. Okay, it started to unscrew. Now, you see, if you begin to unscrew it, it's going to hit this hinge block, and it'll stop. So just turn the hinge block out of the way, just like that. And now this ring can go right past it. And so we just slowly unscrew this retaining ring. Of until it comes completely out of the threaded body. Just like that. So we've removed the retaining ring. You can see the diaphragm. Right here is a spring ring, and it fits into a little cutout in a hole in the side of the reproducer. So we're just going to lift up on this little spring ring, pop it right out of the reproducer. Now see, it's got this little key slot kind of thing here. It fits into a hole, in this case right under the limit loop. Depending on how old the reproducer is, sometimes they're on the side, sometimes they're under the limit loop. So we've removed the little spring ring. So the only thing left to remove is the gaskets themselves. Now, usually these gaskets are literally just falling apart, as this one is. And just run a screwdriver along underneath it. And once the diaphragm is loose, you can usually just lift this completely out of here. Just like that. Now, I've been waiting for a set of gaskets to get here, and they haven't arrived yet. But I just wanted to show you the procedures for dismantling your Model C reproducer. So, as you can see, this one needs to be completely rebuilt. And I ordered some new gaskets. They haven't arrived, but I wanted to go ahead and do the video just to answer a couple of emails, just to show you exactly how this works. So you can see this is the original gasket, and it is literally falling apart. Now, the original gaskets are a really, really thin piece of paper, almost cardboard, and bonded to it is a very, very thin piece of rubber. And there's one on the bottom, and there's one on the top. So when the new gaskets arrive, all you do is you pull off the old one, you clean your diaphragm, you put the new gasket in the bottom, you drop the stylus or the diaphragm back into position, put the new gasket on top of it, line up your little spring ring, and it has a little key slot, like I said, little peg sticking out that fits into the hole directly under the limit loop. And pop it back into position, just like that. And then gently push it down with your tweezers or a small screwdriver. Now you take your retaining ring, put it in position, and slowly tighten it down. Now it's sometimes difficult to get these threads to line up. They're very finely threaded. And so be very cautious that you don't cross-thread it. Because once you cross-thread it, it's very difficult. Now, if your reproducer is made of pot metal, it's very, very difficult in many of them to get this ring out. In some of them, it's virtually impossible to get the ring out. So, we slowly get it started and slowly begin to screw it back down. Little bit at a time, just using your thumb pressure. Now, you'll finally reach a point where it's going to get really tight and it doesn't want to turn anymore. There's a really great trick. You see, you've got these cutouts here for a tool. Surprisingly enough, this is an old razor knife that just perfectly fits across that. And so you can lay the razor knife blade in there and use it as a wrench. Just make sure you take the edge off so you don't cut yourself. And then just give it a turn and just snug that ring up. They don't have to be super tight. Just enough to snug that so you don't get any vibration. That is basically it. If I had replaced the gaskets, we would have just rebuilt this reproducer. So now all we have to do is swing our hinge block back where it goes in position, just like that. Now this is our stylus. And you see it's got a very, very small sapphire. And this sapphire is actually a rod, and it runs through the hole. And there's the end of it, right there. So if the sapphire is actually broken, this is shaped exactly like a glass doorknob. So if the stylus has been damaged, it's still usable. You can apply a small amount of heat. It's held in there with shellac. You can apply a small amount of heat right there just to soften the shellac that's holding it, and then physically turn that stylus to bring up a good side. It's fairly simple to do it. It's just extremely small, and as I said, it's always a good idea, if you've never done this before, to do it on a plate. A plastic frisbee actually works quite well. Just make sure you don't lose any of these parts. Alright, now to reinstall our stylus, there's a trick to this. And all you have to remember is, after you've reconnected the stylus, and it's hanging freely, the stylus itself should be facing the hinge block, just like that. Now, to reassemble this, it's really, really simple. You take the tail weight, let the stylus fall down through the hole, position the pin in the limit loop, and line up the hinge block, just like that. Now the hinge block is lined up. Now you simply take your stylus, swing it up, and stick it down in the little holder that holds the cross pin. Now you take the hinge pin, insert it back into position, and remember, these are extremely small parts, so be very cautious with them. So we install that hinge pin, push it in, and then with our jeweler screwdriver, we just turn it down. There's no head on this. It's actually a threaded pin. So just turn it down a bit. It doesn't have to be flush. In fact, I like to leave it up because it gives you access to the full depth of that slot. If you screw it down too deep, you can actually run out of slot and then you can't get it back out. So I always leave at least two turns sticking out on that pin. It just makes it so much easier to get it back out when you need to. And of course, I'll be dismantling this one again, but I just wanted to show you the procedure. Now, the only thing left to do is line up the hole in the stylus with the hole that supports the pin. And this is the pin, and it is extremely small. It's got about four threads on the top, and the rest of it is an unthreaded pin. So we've lined up the hole in the stylus, and we simply now slide that screw back into the hole and tighten it down. Just enough to snug it. None of these things need to be tight. And that's it. You've just rebuilt the Edison Model C reproducer. Now I'll be doing another video on this, replacing the gaskets. They should be here in the next few days. But as I said, I got a couple of emails asking the procedure. I Googled it. There's a lot of description of doing it, but I had not found a video on how to do it. So I just wanted to do a quick video to show you the procedure. It's really, really simple. It only takes a couple of tools. But remember, these things are extremely small. If you lose them, you've just disabled your reproducer until you can find a replacement. Also, if you have a Model C reproducer and it's already working well, don't take it apart just to take it apart. The old expression, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. I've had a lot of people on other projects where I'll show how to disassemble something, and then I'll get 10 emails from someone who's disassembled something and then can't get it back together again. So it's a very simple process, but it's slow and methodical. And if you've never done it before, take your time, watch the video over and over. It's very simple to do. Most important thing, like I said, don't lose any of the parts. If you lose one of these parts, you've disabled your reproducer, period. So when the new gaskets get here, I'm going to reshoot this video and actually replace them all. Clean the gasket, or clean the diaphragm, clean the inside of the reproducer. And if you have enough parts laying around, I mean, I've got parts everywhere, and I'll run across an old H that's been destroyed, and I'll convert it into a Model C simply by replacing the tail weight. And they're all basically the same. All Edison reproducers are almost all identical as far as the overall construction and how they work and how you repair them. But in any case, I just want to do a really quick video to show you that it is not difficult to do this. It's just a matter of having the right tools, being methodical about it, being slowly, make sure you're not trying to rush anything. And you may have to shape one of these screwdrivers to fit these screws. And you can do that with a small stone or a file. Just make sure that you get a real good true edge on it so it doesn't slip out of these threaded screw or these threaded pins. These heads on these pins are extremely small, and if you destroy this slot, you simply cannot get them out. So in any case, that's the basic rebuilding of the Edison Model C reproducer. This also applies to the H. It applies to almost every reproducer that uses a tail weight. It's really simple to do. Just take your time, be cautious. And like I said, I'll have the new gaskets in the next few days. And the new ones, are made of neoprene. And I'll reshoot this video, completely dismantle this, take the old gaskets out, clean it, put the new gaskets in, rebuild it, reassemble it, and then we'll play it. But as I said, I just wanted to shoot a quick video in answer to a couple of emails I got. So that is rebuilding the Edison Model C reproducer. As I said, it applies to the H. It applies to virtually Edison or any Edison reproducer that uses a tail weight. Very simple procedure, just as long as you know the process so you don't damage anything taking it apart. So as always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. I answer all of my email, try to answer it the day I get it. But if you do have any questions about disassembling the Model C, any questions about the stylus, anything I've covered in my YouTube series, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.